Please welcome Stan Johnson.
Thank you. I got to share something with you. Yesterday they told me I had to speak slow, and I'm sitting there thinking, but I'm from Texas, I already talk slow. I began my speech, oh, by the way, they told me I had to stand behind a line here. I'm thinking, get ready, get set, go, like it's the Olympics. It's, okay. I began my speech last year by quoting the ancient Chinese curse, "May you live in interesting times." Boy, I didn't even realize then just how interesting it was going to get. I wanted to spend this year focused on professionalism. Instead, it was, I want to say it was all politics all the time, but it was politics, regulation, and recession. With your help, we stepped up, and ACCA's opinion was sought throughout the year by the White House, Congress, and multiple federal agencies. We worked closely with other business associations and other associations in our industry. I learned as your chairman that change is not just a shallow political slogan for any single politician or party, it's a fact of life. I read a book last year called Hot, Flat, and Crowded by Thomas Friedman. And I have been recommending it to contractors and everybody I talk to ever since. I got to tell you, Kevin is so tired of me talking to him about that book, I actually found out today that he's read about the first 100 pages of it. I want you to read it not because I expect you to agree with everything Friedman says, but because it lays out in stark detail how global events are impacting you, your business, and your family. We are all confronting changes in a much smaller world, and we need to recognize it, understand it, and deal with it proactively. And this change is compounded by how fast everything moves now. I have been amazed at the speed at which we are now expected to make decisions. A legislative proposal is announced, and we don't even have a week to analyze it, or even a day. You've been reading that in the paper, right? Because right now is the only chance we have to influence it before it changes. Ray Isaac pulled me aside before I became chairman and said, "Stan, if you're going to do this job, you need a BlackBerry." So he was trying to pull me out of, you know, the old-time past that I live in Texas. I am the first to admit that I'm not a tech wizard or geek. Like many of you, I'm just a technology user. If it works, I can use it. If it locks up, well, somebody else is going to have to restart it for me. But Ray kept pushing me. Not long after that, about the time I was about to become chairman, I called my son Eric in Houston and said, "Hey, Eric, I just got one of those new blueberries." Now you can laugh with the rest of my family. We are all becoming connected 24/7. Even those of us who are a little uncomfortable with the new technology. We're not just online when we're at our desk, we're online all of the time. This was a breakout year for things like Facebook, Twitter, and apps for iPhones and new Google phones and ebook readers, I think that's called the Kindle, and a whole slew of stuff that many of us don't understand yet. But we need to understand them because that's where our new customers and employees are going to be coming from. Kevin Holland and the staff at ACCA pushed hard this year to bring us into the forefront of these new communication areas. It's something that is changing our culture, so it is going to change our industry and needs to change our association as well. I am especially proud this year of one change our association made with the adoption of a new constitution and bylaws for the 21st century that will help us move as fast as the internet. Many members and leaders gave countless hours over 2 years to develop new documents that wipe away the outdated confusion and complexity of the old ones. I was gratified that 98% of our members agreed and approved the revisions. Thanks to each of you who worked on the effort, reviewed the documents, made helpful suggestions, and laid the groundwork for a dynamic and growing organization. Last year, we met in Fort Worth. And some of you may recall I took the stage in real personal turmoil. My two sons and my father and his wife were here with us at this meeting, but the rest of my family was missing. Just that morning, our daughter Tara had been taken to a hospital in Corpus Christi, Texas. Tara was 25 weeks pregnant. Delane immediately left Fort Worth to be with her, and the very next night, Tara gave birth to Zane William Adams. He weighed in at 2 pounds and 2 ounces and would fit in the palm of my hand. I can tell you all that this made my incoming chairman's speech last year even more stressful than it would have been, and it also put everything into perspective. So many of you have asked about them during the year and at this meeting and had them in your prayers since last year's banquet. I want to introduce them to you. That's Tara, Jeff, and Zane William Adams. And Mr. Zane was 1 year old on February the 27th, and he now weighs 19 pounds. So thank you for your prayers. As you can tell from looking at Jeff, Zane's gonna be a big boy. Thank you all so much for your prayers and thoughts. Our family really appreciates them. Zane was our fifth grandchild. Since then, in November, we welcomed our sixth grandchild, a little boy named Graham. He's doing well, as are his mom, dad, and big sister.